हरि ओम। लेट अस बिगिन विथ अ स्मॉल प्रेयर। ओम सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांतिः। Chinmaya Vishwavidyapeeth, shortly called CVV, is a deemed to be de novo university in Ernakulam, Kerala. We at CVV believe in celebrating and promoting the scientific heritage of India. To mark the birth anniversary of the genius Srinivasa Ramanujan, which is celebrated across the nation as National Mathematics Day, CVV, in association with the like-minded organization Raising a Mathematician Foundation, is organizing a few events with the objective of popularizing mathematics and celebrating the legacy of Srinivasa Ramanujan. In this context, to promote mathematics among young school students and identify talented young mathematicians, we are organizing the first Sridhara Math Contest. The first round had over 160 registrants, with 139 of them completing the contest on time. We have now gathered for the second and the final round of the contest with 7 finalists. We have with us Professor Nagaraj Neerchal, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Chinmaya Vishwavidyapeeth, Professor Gauri Mahalikar, Honorable Dean of Faculties of Chinmaya Vishwavidyapeeth, Sri Vinay Nair, founder of Raising a Mathematician Foundation, and his team, along with the finalists and our lovely audience. I welcome one and all for this exciting quiz contest. I now request Professor Nagaraj Neerchal to inaugurate the final round of the first Sridhara Math Contest and address the finalists.
Thank you, Ajay. Thank you very, very much. I'm very, very happy to be in this group today. I think the primary reason is that I would say that the average age of today's group is probably way small, and sort of where I would like to be all my life. I think this is I'm guessing that to be in the teens at least. So it's nice to be in this group, because bringing our average age down, of course, I always associate yourself with the average, right? So that is why I feel very, very good about it, to be associated with the average of today in terms of age. And I'm also very happy. I think this is going to be one of the smartest group that I'm in, because you have a whole bunch of very, very talented and mathematically bright students here. And there, I think the average IQ is also way above mine, I'm pretty sure. And so in both cases, I'm happy to be in this group. I would like to mention Vinay Nair and Hari Ramasubramanian, two people who have been associated with this Raising the Mathematician Foundation, which is doing a terrific job of finding the future Ramanujans. I think, as we all know, that geniuses are not just made overnight. They need to be discovered. So there are geniuses all around our country, everywhere, but we need to discover them. Only way to do that is to be in the lookout for the geniuses. And I think these two people have been doing a terrific job of doing that. And so it's very exciting to be in that group as well. Now, I just want to mention that this is, Chinmaya Vishwavidyapeeth is very, very happy to be doing this. This is celebrating Ramanujan, Sridhara, some of the icons of Indian mathematics, both modern and ancient. And CVV's vision is to celebrate the blending of the ancient wisdom and modern science. And so this particular activity that we are doing for the for celebrating Mathematics Day is right along those ideals of CVV. So I want to thank Ajay for doing a terrific job of organizing this event. And I declare the first of many, I hope, Sridhara Mathematics Contest inaugurated.
Thank you very much, Nagaraj. Now I request Professor Gauri Mahulikar to address the finalists.
Yeah, thank you, Ajay. My association with mathematics starts from the name Sridhara. My father was Sridhara, and he did his PG with mathematics and Sanskrit. And I inherited only Sanskrit from him and not mathematics. But then my association with Sridhara and math starts like this. Of course, I know of Bhaskaracharya and his Leelavati. And when my son was doing his SSE way back in 96-97, I had got this Leelavati, got hold of that book. And I told him how beautiful a mathematical example could be. Otherwise, maths is for me a very dry subject. But then the examples stated in Leelavati are so poetic and in the story form. And, you know, I think today's problem is from Leelavati, the elephant sting.
Yes.
It is similar. Oh, yeah. So because I used to tell him about one problem, you know, the peacock is sitting on the tip of a tree and there is a well down, you know. Well, so this is the well. There is a tree behind, a tree besides that. And peacock is sitting on the tip of the tree. So how much distance he will cover if he flies here or from the well, he is to fly there. So this is the diagonal. This forms a triangle, right? So that sort of example. And that Rajakanya, that princess, her pearl necklace is, you know, broken. Some pearls, you know, two-third pearls are in the bed. Two-third got scattered, one-third got scattered, something like that. So how many pearls are, and some few pearls are there in the thread still. So how many pearls were there in the necklace? So such beautiful examples, you know, it was really very engaging and catching. So I'm so happy here that so many young, talented students, girls and boys are participating. I wish this International National Mathematics Day a great success. And by the way, as Nagaraji says, we can find, you know, this Raising a Mathematician Institute is finding a future Ramanujan. And here at CVV, people like Ajay and the faculty are grooming the teachers who would find the Ramanujan. Because we are doing BSc B.Ed. in mathematics. Just remember that. Thank you. Hari Om.
Thank you, Gauriji, for such a wonderful address. So I would also take this opportunity to tell you all that on our social media platforms, on Facebook and Twitter, we have been posting problem a day for you to solve, and you will be really excited to look at the problems, and these are actually problems from ancient Indian mathematics texts. Now I request Vinay Nayarji to take over and carry on.
Thank you, Ajayji. Thank you, Nagaraji, Gauriji, for your words of encouragement, and wishing all the participants and welcoming all of us. So I'll just quickly do a quick introduction. I have with me my friends here, Sai and Hetvi. They are from Raising a Mathematician Foundation. Sai is going to be our scorekeeper, and Hetvi is going to be our third umpire. So just to check if everything is okay. And I have with us Hariharan, who is the head of academic affairs of Raising a Mathematician Foundation. And we have all these wonderful math enthusiasts with us. So I'm really excited and looking forward to this quiz. But before I do that, I thought, let me just do, you know, one quick quiz with all of you. Okay, so this is a quick quiz before the quiz. So I'm going to give you some clues and you have to guess the personality. And to guess this personality, whoever gets the answer, you can do a raise hand option. And participants don't have to worry. The points don't get carried over, you know, even if it is positive or negative to the quiz. This is just a teaser before the show. Okay. So here's the first quiz. He gave his TEDx talk at the age of 13 on mathematics, magic, and music. So if you get the answer, if you think you can guess this personality, just raise your hand. No? Okay. Going to the next clue. He came up with 25 conjectures in primes when he was just 15 years old. Okay, Rohan has raised hand. All right, Rohan, you can post your answer in the chat. Okay, you can post it to me. Wait, Rohan, don't unmute Rohan. I don't want Rohan to give away. I'll give a chance to the other participants with the third clue. Before he was 20, he was invited twice to several universities in the US to give talks. Rohan, your answer is incorrect. Aishwarya, if you get the answer, yes, Aishwarya has got the answer, and I'll give away the fourth clue as well. He is the author of a book called Math, A Subtle Language of the Universe, and is currently pursuing his undergraduate in mathematics from the University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign. Anyone else got the answer? Nobody? Okay, I'll show a picture of his. Rohan got the answer now. And the answer is not me, the fellow who's sitting next to me. Okay, and he is our quiz master, Raghavendra Bhatt. And this picture is taken during one of the camps that he had been part of at Chinmaya International Foundation when he was 13 years old. Raghav, can you just switch on your video? Yes, there's Raghavendra, now. So Raghavendra is going to be our quiz master for today, and over to you, Raghav.
Sorry. Yes, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whichever part of the world you might be. First of all, I thank Vinay sir for that surprise introduction. It was not expected. I also thank CVV and Raising a Mathematician for coordinating this program, and it's an honor for me to host this event, and I'm really happy to see all these young budding mathematicians. So let's get started with the quiz, and I will start sharing my screen. Let's have a great time, and let's have a lot of fun, because the most important thing is to have fun today. We don't mind who wins or who loses. We all want to have fun, and I'm here to have fun as well. So this is the Sridhar Math Contest 2020, and I welcome you all. It is the 16th of December 2020, and as you can see from that right angle triangle, 12 squared plus 16 squared is 20 squared. 144, 256 add up to 400, and that is today's date. So I think that's a good sign from up above that today is a mathematical date, and great things might happen on this date. Okay, let's get started. We have 7 finalists from the 160 odd people who had participated in the first round. We have Davin, we have Kanav, we have Manu, we have Aishwarya, we have Rohan, Shreyas, and Charan. So before I get started, I would like to give this opportunity to each of our finalists to speak for a moment about themselves. You know, tell us who you are, where you're from, what you're doing, and also tell us your one thing in mathematics that you like. So let's start with Davin.
I'm Davin. I'm studying 9th grade, and I'm from Chennai. And the one thing on mathematics I like, I don't know.
That's okay. Thank you so much, Davin. Maybe if he cannot pick one thing, it means he likes more than two things. So that's a great thing. Now let us go to Kanav, the next participant.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes.
My name is Kanav Talwar, and I'm from Noida, and I'm in class 7. And I really like number theory and combinatorics in maths.
Wonderful. Welcome. Now let's go to the third contestant, Manu.
My name is Manu, and I'm from Bangalore. I'm in grade 7, and I like everything in math apart from doing arithmetic calculations.
Okay. Welcome. The next participant is Aishwarya Abhyankar.
Hello, everybody. My name is Aishwarya, and I'm from Jnanaprabodhini Prashala, Pune. The thing that I like about mathematics is that I like to write about it. So I also like writing. Sanskrit is my favorite language, you could say. So I had once tried to write a sort of stotra about maths in Sanskrit. The grammar is not that good, but it was just a trial, and that's it.
Oh, that's so inspiring. Very, very nice to hear that. The next participant is Rohan.
Hello, I'm Rohan. I'm in grade 10 and I'm in Pune. I'm living in Pune. And I really like number theory in mathematics.
So we have one thing in common then. Okay, next we go to Shreyas.
Yes, I'm Shreyas. I'm in class 9. I'm from Chennai. The thing I like in Max is the geometry and combinatorics.
Very nice. And our last participant, Charan.
Yeah, hello. I'm Charan Karthik from Kurnool, Andhra Pradesh, studying 10th grade. I really like mathematics and mainly the part of statistics, area and volume.
Wonderful. Very nice to see you all and hear from you. Welcome once again. My name is Raghavendra Bhatt and I will be your quiz master for today. And as I said, let's all look forward to have a lot of fun. And so this quiz is divided into three rounds. And before we get started, I would quickly like to give you an overview of what those three rounds are called, and we can get into the rules. The first round is called Think Different. The second round is called Tell Me the Answer, O Ganaka. And as Dr. Gauri had just mentioned, this is how Bhaskaracharya addressed the questions in his book Leelavati. So it means tell me the answer, O mathematician. And the third round is my favorite round, which is identify the mathematician. So let us get started with the first round, which is called Think Different. And here are the rules to the round. Every participant will be directed one particular question. Okay, so we go one question to each person, which is specifically directed to you. If you answer it correctly within your time limit, which is 40 seconds, you will see a timer on the screen. You get 100 points. If you are not able to answer the question and you pass it, it goes to the next person who has to answer it instantly. And that person, if answered correctly, gets 50 points. Okay. There is no negative marking for this round. So either you can get 100 points or you can get 0 or you can get 50. Are there any questions? Okay. Let's get started. The first question is to Aishwarya. And this is your question. What is the minimum number of colors that you need to color a hexagonal grid such that no two adjacent cells have the same color? You can look at the diagram for reference, and your time starts now.
Three.
Okay, so your answer is 3, and the answer is 3. You're right. Please give her 100 points. So we have started off on a great note. Congratulations. Wonderful. Okay, let's move on to the next question, which is directed to Kanav. And your question is, how do you cut a rectangle which has a circle inside it, as shown in the figure, such that both the rectangle and the circle are divided into two equal parts? So how do you cut this such that both of them are divided equal parts? Okay, your time starts now.
Diagonally and from the diameter of the circle.
Can you repeat your answer?
So not exactly diagonally from the corners, but from the edges and passing through the diameter of the circle.
I think it's a little unclear what you were trying to say. So maybe we will pass it on to the next person, who is Davin. Does Davin have an answer to this question? Like a quick answer?
Yes, I have an answer.
Okay, what's your answer?
Take the center of the rectangle and the center of the circle and then connect them with the line. Then one line will cut both both the shapes into two parts equally.
Okay, I will take that answer, although I required a little more clarity, but I think whatever you presented was the correct idea. So we can give him 50 points for answering the past question. The exact way to, you know, frame your thoughts would be cut it through the center of the circle and the point of intersection of the diagonals of the rectangle. So you meant the center of the rectangle, which I feel is the same thing. So I don't mind giving you the point. So you know, intersect the two diagonals, you pick that point, which is like an informal way of saying the center of the rectangle, and then you can you know, connect it through the center of the circle, one line, and divides both of them into two halves. Wonderful. He gets 50 points. Now the question is directed to Davin. And your question is, find the area of a tessellation if the length of the square with dark edges is one unit. So this is your shape. You have to find the area of this entire figure. And the length of the square with the dark edges is one unit. So this square is one unit. And your time starts now.
Sir, what do you mean? Which line again, sir? The unit of the graph.
Yes. The unit of the graph is one unit. Yes, this big square.
Then the area is 64.
64 is your answer?
Yes.
Okay. I think your answer is right. Wonderful. So now you get your 50 points plus your 100 points. That's a good start for you in round one. Okay, things are moving along fast. Now let's move to question four, which is directed to Charan. I hope he's ready. Okay, and your question is, with two congruent right angle triangles as given in the figure, the orange one and the blue one, how many shapes can you make by joining the congruent sides to each other perfectly? And I think the question is self-explanatory, so I will start the timer now. You have 10 seconds left.
Yeah.
Very good. And I would be very happy to tell you that your answer is also correct. Yes, there are three congruent pairs of sides and you can, you know, do some combinations with them and you can get six different shapes. Wonderful. And now the fifth participant, Manu, this is the fifth question of the first round. And your question is, what is the minimum number of hexagons that needs to be rearranged so that the image looks inverted? This is the image. What is the minimum number that you need to invert the image? And your time starts now.
Five.
Your answer is five, which is incorrect. So I would like to pass the question to Shreyas. Can you quickly tell us the answer, if you know it, Shreyas?
Hello, sir. Is it six? Five.
Your answer is six. That is also incorrect. And we will do one more passing to Rohan. Does Rohan have the answer?
Is it four?
Four. Not quite. And I would like to stop the passing here. The reason is because I think the sample set is very small here. So just by random guessing, it's highly likely that the next person will get it because we all know that it's some small number. So I will stop the passing here. So I would not like to give points to anybody for this one. The correct answer is three. So since we were going 6-5-4, I thought it's intuitive that the next person would say 3-2-1. So it's only fair to everybody that we stopped it. It's like if it's a multiple choice question with four options, you cannot give four shots at the answer, right? So, okay, we have one final question remaining in the first round.
Do you want to share the answer, how it can be done? Can you just go back or maybe can I just
say
something? Okay.
Yes.
So the answer is you look at the corner pieces on the top edge, you bring them to the third row, the corner pieces. You bring them to the third row and you take the bottom piece above. Right? So you get that. Raghavendra, can you just use the pointer and show?
Sure. So this one and this one, you bring them over here and here. And then you take this one and you put it at the top. So then you have again 4, 3, 2, and this one goes to the top. So you just moved three things. Is that clear, everybody? Okay, very nice. So the last question of the first round directed to Rohan. Shreyas, sorry. The second last question to the last round, my bad. Okay. Find the numbers in the place of the question mark if the sum of every row, column, and diagonal is 34. Okay, and the grid is filled with numbers from 1 to 16 only. So this is the box, and you have to find the two numbers that will replace this question mark. And I will quickly take a moment to tell you what it means when you look at these blue and green boxes. It means that this blue rectangle here should add up to 20, or this green thing over here has to add up to 23. Okay, so using that, can you find the two question mark numbers? And your time starts now.
I'm passing the question.
You're passing the question? Okay. Now the question is passed to Rohan. Does Rohan have the answer?
Is it even I'm passing?
You're passing it too. Okay. Now it goes to Aishwarya. Do you know the answer to this?
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you're audible.
Sir, the first question mark on the left, it is, mm-hmm. Is it 14?
You're right.
And the second one is 9.
Very good. Okay. So you get 50 points for answering the past question correctly. Okay. I think, yeah, the answer is 14 and 9. Very good. And now we move to the final question of the first round, which is directed to Rohan. What is the minimum number of cuts that you need to cut a sphere into 8 equal parts? Okay, and your time starts now. It's a self-explanatory question. So how many cuts do you need to cut a sphere into 8 equal parts? Minimum number of cuts.
Is it 4?
The answer is not 4. And I will pass it to Aishwarya. Do you know the answer?
3.
Yes, you're right. The answer is 3. You can cut it along the horizontal, the vertical, and also the Z axis. So if you think about it in 3D, and initially when I looked at it, I thought it's 4 as well, but yeah, then I realized it's 3. So 4 is also, it's possible to cut it into parts using 4, but the minimum one is going to be 3. Okay, so that brings us to the end of our first round. And I would like to ask Sai, who's our scorekeeper, to tell us everybody where we stand. What are the scores?
All right, so we have Aishwarya leading with 200 points, Devin at the second place with 150 points, Charan at the third place with 100 points. Kanav, Manu, Rohan, and Shreyas all have 0 points.
Okay. And nothing to worry, guys. A lot of opportunities to make up for your scores, and the stakes might even get bigger and better later on. So let's see. Moving on to the second round. Tell me the answer, O Ganaka. Okay. Tell me the answer, O young mathematician. And this is how the second round will pan out. Again, every question will be first directed to a participant, as it was in the first round. But this time you have 60 seconds, not 40. And if you answer it correctly, you get 200 points. Not 100 points, but you get 200 points. Okay. If you don't answer it, the question is straight away passed on to the next participant. If they give the correct answer immediately, they get 100 points. Otherwise, it keeps passing on, depending on the nature of the question. Sometimes we can pass it to everybody. But the clink in the armor here is if you don't get the right answer, if you get the wrong answer, you get negative 50 points. Okay, so in the hurry to get the right answer, you have to be, you know, you have to be very careful. You not only you can get 200 extra points, but you might also lose 50 points. Yes, somebody has raised their hand. What is your question?
Sir, if someone passes it before the 60 seconds are over, does the next person get at the 60 seconds?
Yes. So we can count from wherever the timer has stopped. So you can take up to 60 seconds for the first proper reaction to this question.
Yeah.
And there is no negative marking for a passing. So once the question has passed, then there is no negative points. The negative point is only incorrect answers by any participant gets them 50 negative points. I'm sorry, the negative point is there for everybody. 50 negative points for everybody. For the person who's directed the question, they get 200 correct points. And if it's passed, they only get 100 points. So basically the risk is lower for you if the question is directed to you. Okay. Let's start with the round. I repeat, there is negative marking for everybody. Okay. So the first question is to Manu. Two bamboos of length 10 and 15 are tied to each other's base with ropes. Do you need more information to calculate the point of intersection of the ropes? If so, what else do you need? If not, what is the height of the point of intersection of the ropes from the base? Okay. And your time starts now. So the point of intersection of the ropes from the ground, the length of the red line, that's what you have to calculate. The question is whether there is enough information or no. If yes, what's the answer? Okay. 2-1, and the question passes to Shreyas. If you get it right, you can get 100 points. If you get it wrong, negative 50.
I'm passing it.
You're passing it. Okay, it moves to Aishwarya. Do you know the right answer?
Pass, sir.
Pass. Okay, it passes to Kanav.
Yes, sir.
Yes, do you wish to attempt this question? I take it as a no. Okay, it passes now to Charan. Charan, do you know the answer to this or do you pass it as well? Okay, it passes to Rohan. Okay, he passes it. And the last one, Davin. So this is the last pass. Does Davin know the answer to this question?
Six.
Okay, that's the right answer. And you win 100 points. Wonderful. Okay. Now the second question of the second round. Tell me, Oganaka.
Just 1 second. Can we ask Davin how did he compute the answer? Or maybe in the interest of time, I can just say. So this question is from history of Indian mathematics, and you just need similarity to calculate what is the area of this particular height. And I leave the calculation to the audience. Yes, go ahead.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you, sir. We move on to the second question of this round, and it is directed to Shreyas. And the question is, what is the length of the diameter of a cyclic quadrilateral whose side lengths are in the order 39, 52, 25, and 60, and the quadrilateral has one pair of opposite angles as right angles. And here is the figure for you to get a rough idea. You have to calculate the diameter of this cyclic quadrilateral. So basically the diameter of the circle, and your time starts now.
Sir,
yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Is the answer 65?
Your answer is 65. That's the right answer. Wonderful. You win 200 points. And a slight trivia on this particular question. This was the most interesting question for me in the first camp that I ever attended in my life. That was in 2013. And in the picture which Vinay sir shared of me and him talking, it is highly likely that we were discussing this one, because in that camp, the main topic was cyclic quadrilaterals, and we were figuring out how to come up with ways to calculate the diagonal of a circle, the diameter of a circle really quickly. So this is that same question with the same sides that I had first looked at. It's a very close question to my heart. And the answer is 65. Well done, Shreyas. Okay, moving on. The third question of this round to Aishwarya. Okay, another geometry question. You have AB equals 13 centimeters, BC equals 4 centimeters, and AC equals 15 centimeters. Okay. By the way, there is no figure given here for this question. So if you want to start drawing, you can start. AD is perpendicular to BC and D lies on BC. Find the length of AD and BD. Okay. And your time starts now. What are the lengths of AD and BD? Okay, the question now passes to Kanav. Do you know the answer, or does it? Okay. Kanav, do you have the answer?
1 minute, I need to unmute Kanav. Just a minute.
Yes.
So is the answer 9? AD is equal to 9 and BD is equal to root 88?
Oh, I'm sorry, Kanav, but that's the wrong answer. The correct answer for AD is 12 and the correct answer for BD is 5. So we can stop it here. And I think it's negative 50 points for Kanav. I'm sorry about that. So the answer is 12 and 5. Okay. Right, moving on. The next question is directed to Kanav. So no problem, Kanav. If you get it right, you can make up for the minus 50 by getting plus 200. So all the best. And your question is, find the number in the question mark if the numbers in the triangle follow the principle in Pascal's triangle, which is also called Varnameru in ancient Indian texts. So this one, what is the number that will replace the question mark? And your time starts now. So the logic is based on the Pascal's triangle logic. You can see what adds up to what, and based on that logic, you have to figure out what is that question mark.
Sir, what is the number in that third row middle triangle?
Third row middle triangle.
1716.
1716. 171. Okay. You can take 15 more seconds because there was a clarification in the middle. You have 10 more seconds. Okay. The question now passes on to Charan. Yes, Charan. Charan, do you want to attempt this question?
Yes, sir. The answer is the answer 6435.
You're right, perfectly right. That's 100 points. Well done, Charan. The answer is 6435. So the question was passed. So he gets 100 points. Well done. Okay, now the question is directed to Charan. Just a reminder, guys, we have three more questions remaining in this round. Charan, Rohan, and Devin. Okay, the question now is to Charan. And your question is this. Find the difference in diameters of both the circles in this diagram if the radius of the red circle is 0.5 units. So there is a red circle, there is a green square, and there is another blue or black circle in the middle. So you have to find the difference in diameters between the red circle and the middle circle, which is blue or black, depending on what you see it. And your time starts now. The radius of the red circle is 0.5 units. Okay.
0.4. Is it 0.4?
0.4. No, that is not the right answer. So I think you get a negative 50 points. However, I will allow two more passes to this question just to avoid trial and error. And now the question passes to Rohan. Does Rohan know the answer to this?
Is it root of half in brackets root of half minus one?
Root of half in brackets, root of, can you repeat your answer?
Root of half minus one into root of half.
Root of half minus one into root of half?
Yeah.
No, that's not the right answer. And we will allow one more pass, that is to Devin. Does Devin have the answer? So that's negative 50 points for Rohan. You are very close actually, but let's see. One final.
Sir.
Yes.
1 minus root of half.
1 minus root of half. You are right. So he gets 100 points. So it's 1 minus square root of half. The other way to put it is also you can say root 2 minus 1, the whole thing divided by root 2. So I think you got the signs interchanged, which is why I wanted to make sure that you were, there's no communication gap, but anyway, well done. So this is easy to solve, guys. You can just first start off by getting, you know, the radius of one circle, then the square, and then you can use that diagonal of the square to estimate the other thing, and then you can subtract. Okay. So moving on to the next question, which is related to Rohan. So both, Rohan can make up for whatever he lost. The question is find the next term in the sequence. Okay, look at the sequence very closely because the pattern might not start kicking in until a little bit later. So don't jump to a conclusion. Look at it for some time. 1, 2, 3, 6, 10, 19, 33, 60, 106 and what? And your time starts now. The question is directed to Rohan. Seconds to go. Come on. Okay. Your time is up. And now the question passes to Devin. You have the answer with you, Devin? Hi. Yes.
Sir, you have an answer? Pass.
You want to pass? Okay. No issues. Let's pass it on to Manu. Manu, do you know the answer to this question?
Sir, I'll pass.
You pass. Okay. Shreyas, any luck with the answer?
I pass, sir.
You pass as well. Okay. Aishwarya? Do you have the answer?
No, sir. Pass.
You pass. Okay. Kanav?
Sir, pass.
You pass. Okay. And the final pass to Charan. Do you have the answer?
Pass, sir.
You pass. Okay.
Do you want to ask the audience?
Yes, I was thinking of doing that, but I thought Hariharan sir will get it. So
no, he's okay. Not there. We have others. Anyone from the audience wish to give it a shot, you can do a raise hand, or if they are the co-host, they can just unmute themselves.
Does anybody from the audience have the answer to this question? It's closely related to the Hemachandra sequence, which is also called the Fibonacci sequence, but it's different.
Okay, nobody. I think you okay. Can go ahead.
Okay, the right answer is 191. So the way to do it is you do Sn minus 1 plus Sn minus 2 plus Sn minus 4 plus Sn minus 6. So you add 4 terms to get the next one. So for example, from 33, if you have to go to 60, you add 19 plus 10 plus 3 plus 1. So from 60 to 106, you do 60 plus 33 plus 10 plus 3. So now we do 106 plus 60 plus 19 plus 6, which is 191. Okay. There it is. And now the last question.
Can I just say something about that sequence?
Yes, sir.
This sequence is closely connected to music, especially percussion instruments. So if you take tabla bowls, there is Drita, Laghu, Guru, Pluta. And Drita is one beat, and you can say Laghu is two beats, and 1, 2, 4, 6 in that way. So when you convert this into a number theory problem, this 191 is the number of that you can create whose sum of the digits is 10. Using the digits 1, 2, 4, 6.
Yeah.
And this 106 is the number of possible numbers that you can create using 1, 2, 4, 6, whose sum of the digits is 9, and so on. That is the number of possible combinations that you can create in percussion instruments music. And this is from Sharangadeva's text, Sangeeta Ratnakara, written around 11th or 12th century.
So this is so beautiful because it combines combinatorics, Sanskrit, because of the syllables, and also number theory to create music. So that is a way how ancient Indian mathematicians operated. They were polymaths. There was not one person who was good at one thing. He was good in multiple things. So there was a poet, mathematician, astrologer, philosopher, Sanskrit scholar, all in one. Okay, so moving on to the last question of this round. Tell me the answer, O Ganaka. That is to Devin. And this is your question. The below expression was given by someone to compute the value of dash. So what is this used for calculating this approximation? This exact equation. and your time starts now. Yeah, sorry.
Sir, I want to pass.
You want to pass it? Okay, let's just stop the timer and let's move on to the next person, that is Manu. Manu, do you have the answer to this question?
Sir, is it square root of 2?
Square root of 2. Yes, you are right. So you get 100 points. Well done. Do you want to tell us how you got it or did you just know it?
Sir, I just took that 1 plus 1 by 3 was approximately 1.3. And then okay. I didn't bother calc. I just added 1 by 12 because I didn't care about the difference of 1 and 1 by 32 and I got somewhere near 1.4.
Very nice. Very nice. For those of you who do not have these, you know, abilities to do it at lightning fast speed, the information that I'm giving is that this was actually by Bodhayana in his Sulva Sutras. Those are geometrical based texts. So he gave this formula to compute the value of root 2. Okay. Now, before we move on to the next round, let us see where we stand at the end of round 2. So Manu gets the 100 points for answering that correctly. And the answer is root 2. Which is approximately 577 upon 408, which is a very good approximation for root 2. And Sai, can you please tell us the scores after round 2?
Yes. Aishwarya earned 0 points this round. Sharan got 50 more points. Devin got 200 more points. Kanav lost 50 points. Manu got 100 points. Rohan lost 50 points. And Shreyas earned 200 more points.
Okay, wonderful. So can you tell us the cumulative score, if it's possible? Overall, what's the total? Hello, Sai?
Yes, sorry. So Devin is leading with 350 points. After Devin, Shreyas and Aishwarya are leading with 200 points. After both of them, Charan comes with 150 points. Then we have Manu with 100 points. And then we have Rohan and Kanav with negative 50 points.
Okay, good to know. And now we move on to the last round of this quiz, which should be the most entertaining for everybody because there is no math involved here in terms of calculation. Okay, Manu raised your hand. You have a question? No? Okay, good. So there is no calculation involved. You don't have to, you know, get scraps of paper and hurry. You just have to guess who the mathematician is. Identify the mathematician, and this should be very interesting. And let us go over the rules. So this is a buzzer round where the first person to raise his hand gets the first chance to guess the answer. Okay? And you'll be given 4 clues. So pay attention, everybody. This is a little, it's tricky. You have to pay attention to the rules. There are 4 clues. And they will be given one by one, not at the same time. If somebody gives me the right answer, as soon as they see the first clue, they get 400 points. 400 points, I repeat, okay? If you get the answer on the second clue, you get 300 points. Then I give you the third clue. By the way, if somebody gets the answer, before we go to the third clue, we go to the next question, okay? But the first possible answer, okay? If you get it on the third clue, you get 200 points. Or if you get it on the fourth clue, that is the last clue with regard to the mathematician, you get 100 points. At any point of time, if you give the wrong answer, you lose and you get a negative of the 50% of the stakes of that question. So if it was the first attempt, you lose 200 points. If it was the second clue attempt, then you lose 150 points. If you got the wrong answer on the third clue, you lose 100 points. And if you get the wrong answer on the fourth clue, you lose 50 points. Okay? And here's the thing. If you decide to raise your hand, that's it. You are taken into consideration and you have to give the answer. You cannot raise your hand once and then say, oh no, now based on the second clue, my answer has changed or something like that. No. As soon as you raise your hand, you have to answer the question. Okay? Any questions at this point of time before we go into this final round? Keep your mouse pointers ready. And I think we have people who will be checking who is the first person to raise their hand, and that person will get the opportunity. Okay? The stakes are high and anybody has the chance to win this. Even if you're at negative 50, even if you're at 200. Be attentive and here we go. So this is actually open to everybody, right? Or is it directed to...
No, it's open to everybody. Just ignore the names on top.
Yes. Open to everybody. Okay, this is not directed to anybody. All of you can attempt all the questions at the same time. Okay, the first question is this. The clue one. This mathematician is known to have collaborated with the maximum number of mathematicians of his time. Okay, Manu, what's your answer?
Euler.
That is not the... Yes, sir?
Incorrect
answer. So you lose 200 points. Do we go forward? Let's allow other people to...
Yes, okay. Of course.
Let's move on to the second clue. That's a good shot, but unfortunately, no. Clue number two. The same mathematician never stayed at a place and always kept traveling with two suitcases, one that contained his or her papers and the other his or her clothes. Anybody now? Okay, Karan has raised his hand. Do you want to attempt? Yes.
Eldosh,
you're right. Well done. So he gets 300 points. Well done, Karan. And Kanav, my mistake. Kanav. And welcome to the quiz. I think you have opened your account and you have just smashed in front of everybody with 300 points. Well done. This is Paul Eldosh, guys. And let's just look at the other clues. The third clue would have been his picture. Maximum number of collaborations in the last century, almost. In the 20th century, very famous mathematician. He gave himself the number zero. And anyone who collaborated with him, the number one. So this is called the famous, you call Eldosh number. If you write a paper with him, you get an Eldosh number of one. And anyone who has collaborated with one of his collaborators gets an Eldosh number of two. And a fun fact is I have a professor in my next semester, Bruce Resnick here, who has an Eldosh number of two. So he has worked with somebody who worked with Eldosh. So
can you stop sharing? And let me just ask Hariharan sir, if he can just say something about Eldosh. Hariharan, I remember you had said something about Eldosh number and Nobel laureates.
Yes, so that was interesting that Manu said Euler first, and Euler was more of a single authored person. So most of his ideas, if you
Hariharan,
see...
Hariharan, sir, it would be good if you can speak about Eldosh.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm coming to that. So he was more of a loner.
In the interest of time.
Yeah. Eldosh number is a very famous number because you can get to how far you are from Paul Eldosh, and many Nobel laureates are Paul Eldosh number two. They have number two. So that means they have mostly collaborated with someone who has collaborated with Paul Eldosh. So many Nobel laureates have Paul Eldosh number two.
Okay, thank you, Hariharan sir. Raghavendra.
Okay, let's start again. Let's go ahead with our quiz. So that the answer was Paul Eldosh, 1913 to 1996, one of the most celebrated mathematicians of the last century. Okay, moving ahead, ignore the name. It is directed to everybody. The first clue, he posed the question, find the positive integer solutions for x squared minus 61y squared equals 1. in the mid 17th century? Okay, somebody has raised their hand. What's your answer?
Was it John Pell?
That is a wrong answer.
Charan?
Well tried. Now it's Charan's turn. What's your answer?
We should move on.
Okay. Anyone else? Oh, you have to. Okay. So he doesn't have to give an answer?
So he gets a negative 200. He gets both of them to get a negative 200.
Okay. Moving on. The second clue is he claimed to know the proof of a conjecture but died before giving the proof. The conjecture was proved 350 years later. Okay, Rohan, again.
It was Fermat.
Fermat, you're right. Pierre de Fermat, and that's the right answer. You win 300 points. So it's a very good situation for you. You lost 200, but you got 300. So you are back in the positive. Okay, guys, let's just look at the other clues. So this is obviously the famous Fermat's last. Now it's the theorem, but was the conjecture. He also stated that any prime number of the form 4a plus 1 can be uniquely expressed as the sum of two squares. And the fourth clue would have been the fact that he was a lawyer by profession and is known as the father of modern day number theory. A wonderful, wonderful mathematician. The conjecture was proved, I think, in 1995 by Andrew Wiles. So here he is, Pierre de Fermat, 1607 to 1665. Okay, moving on. This is the third one. The first clue, he was the first mathematician to give a method to solve the Pell's equation x squared minus dy squared equals 1 for certain values of d. So somebody had mentioned Pell in the previous one and here he shows up. Anybody? Okay, Rohan, what's your answer?
It was Bocard.
Nope, your answer is wrong. Negative 200. Moving on. Oh, I think Charan has also raised his hand. Yes, and Aishwarya has also raised her hand. Okay. What's Charan?
Is it Bhaskaracharya? Bhaskaracharya?
It is not Bhaskaracharya. Okay, Aishwarya, what is your answer?
My answer was also Bhaskaracharya. So does it count? So
yes, it counts. Because you didn't know the fact that he was also saying Bhaskaracharya. So you lose 200 points. I'm sorry about that. Yes, negative 200. Okay, the next clue. He gave a formula to compute the length of a diagonal of a cyclic quadrilateral. Oh, where have we seen this before? Using the side lengths of the cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, Rohan.
It was Brahmagupta.
Well done. 300 points. So you are making this a habit of getting it wrong in the first attempt and then getting it right on the next one. Very good. So you get your 300 points. Well done. Look at the other clues. He was the first mathematician to give rules for operations with zero and negative integers. How many of you knew that? The first mathematician in general, not first Indian, first Asian, nothing. The first mathematician. Maybe zero, whether it was invented in India or no, we can debate about that. But he was the first guy to actually give operations with zero and negative integers. Wonderful mathematician. And the fourth clue was, it was his works from which the Arabs learned astronomy before they got acquainted with the Greeks' works. So Brahmagupta was a stalwart in ancient Indian mathematics. And he was also responsible for all those cyclic quadrilateral formulas. He's also called the Ganaka Chakra Chudamani, the jewel among the circle of mathematicians. This title was given to him by Bhaskaracharya, who was also among the answers that were given in the last round. So 598 AD to 668.
Raghavendra, yes, if I may add something, can you just go back to the clues? Just go back to the clues. So those who said Bhaskaracharya, here, I think you missed the word. He was the first mathematician to give for certain values of D. Bhaskaracharya, definitely, he gave a generalized solution with Chakravala and all. But Brahmagupta was the first one to talk about for certain values of D. I think that is where there was a catch. So good attempt, guys. Aishwarya and Charan, I think. Yeah.
Okay. Moving on. That's Brahmagupta. Well done, Rohan. Okay. More than 220 papers of his got published after he died. Okay. Aishwarya has raised her hand.
Euler.
Well done. 400 points. maybe a little too obvious after the discussion that we had earlier, but very well done, very well done. Euler, Gauss contributed 79 mathematical terms to the world, Ramanujan contributed 35, and this mathematician gave 109. Probably the greatest mathematician of the last 500 years, which is a debatable thing, but if we did a poll all over the world, maybe people would rate him really, really up there. He lost vision of one eye when he was 23 years old, lost vision in the other when he was 64. People read his papers, and that's how he kept himself updated. At 68, he started publishing a research paper per week. Guys, just understand, publishing one research paper in a year is an extraordinary achievement. And most, you know, active mathematicians achieve that in a good career, maybe one or two papers in a year, sometimes maybe five if they're extremely good. But this guy was doing once a week. That's about 50 papers in a year, which is absolutely ridiculous. And to solve the seven bridges problem, he created a new branch of mathematics. Okay. Wonderful. Euler, read Euler, read Euler. He is the master of us all. That's what Laplace said. So if Laplace is saying that, then maybe it will hold a lot of water. Okay, here we go. The last one. The first clue. He hailed from Madras and was a fellow of the Royal Society. Aishwarya, you get the first shot.
Srinivas Ramanujan.
Wrong. And wrong. How many?
Everybody. Wait, let me quickly.
Wait, let's just make sure Rohan. That everybody was.
Yeah, yeah. Rohan, so. Yeah.
My answer is.
Was it Ramanujan before Aishwarya said Ramanujan? Or did it change after? Okay, 200 points okay. Gone. Pranam, was it also Ramanujan? Be honest, guys. That's okay.
No, it's one second. It's Shreyas, and then Kanav, and then Manu.
And Manu. Yes.
Yeah. Shreyas.
Yes, mine was also Ramanujan, sir.
Okay. Kanav.
Mine was also Ramanujan.
Okay, and Manu.
Mine was also Ramanujan.
Okay.
Davin didn't raise his hand. Is that correct? Hetvi, did anyone? I think some of them raised their hand and then lowered it. Hetvi, was Davin there in that?
No, I think Kanav raised his hand and then lowered it and again.
Okay.
So all of you,
Sir, except Davin.
Yes, Sai.
What about Charan?
Charan also raised his hand, right? Or he didn't?
I think we asked him his answer though.
Okay. Charan, did you raise your hand? Hetvi, can you tell us?
No, sir. No, I didn't raise my hand.
He hadn't raised his hand.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay,
so everybody except Davin and Kanav lose 200 points.
Davin but and guys, Charan.
Charan, sorry. I'm happy that you guys thought of Ramanujan, but unfortunately, he is not the right answer here.
Where did we go wrong? You know, I think here I would just want to share something. The people in the north think everybody who's down south is a Madrasi and everybody is from Madras. That is not true. Ramanujan was not from Madras. He lived in Madras for some time, but he didn't hail from Madras.
Yes. Okay. Ramanujan was from a small town called Erode, which is not too far from Chennai, but anyway, let's move on. Yes, Manu, what's your question?
I'm in Erode right now.
What's that?
I'm in Erode right now.
He is in Erode right now.
Oh, you are in Erode. Oh, okay. Wonderful. Okay, the next clue. He has a constant and also a theorem named after him. Does that ring a bell, anybody? Okay, Manu. You want to go again?
Is it Bose?
It's not Bose. You lose 150 points. I'm sorry. Okay, let's move on. Clue number three. Was equally passionate about Indian Carnatic music as much as mathematics. Does this tempt anybody to go for it? Okay, Davin.
Is it C.V. Raman?
It's not C.V. Raman. You lose another 100 points. Not another 100 points. You lose 100 points. Okay, the last clue for the last question. Without him, we wouldn't have had one of the best institutes in India for math, CS, and theoretical physics, the Chennai Mathematical Institute. Okay, Kanav.
Sheshadri.
Yes, you're right. Sheshadri is the correct pronunciation, but you're right. So you win 100 points. Well done. And the correct answer is C.S. Seshadri, the founder of CMI. Okay, 1932 to 2020.
He has a theorem named after him, Seshadri and somebody else.
Seshadri Narasimhan theorem.
Yes. Thank you, Ajay. Seshadri Narasimhan theorem, and he has got Seshadri constant named after him. Thank you, Ajay. And okay. By the way, Ajay has got Erdos number 6.
Ah, awesome. So there is a popular philosophy that says that any person in this world can be connected to another person by 6 different people, not in mathematics, based on how many you know. So the similar logic is probably used in Erdos, and the number 6 just reminded me of that. But I don't think you can connect to Erdos via 6 for everybody. So you would have had to work with somebody. So if you don't have a publication, you cannot be connected to Erdos. But the philosophy is in general. I will know somebody who will know somebody, and so on. Okay. So, I'm sorry. There is one more question. My bad, guys. There is one more question. I'm sorry. There's one more question. And the first clue is Iranian mathematician and professor at Stanford who was the recipient of the highest award in mathematics. Does anybody know the answer to this one? No? Okay. Let's move on. And I would like to tell you all that there are a few more questions. I'm sorry. I was looking at some older presentation where we had stopped it here, but there are a few more questions. Second clue is, always wanted to be a writer and only thought of becoming a mathematician until the last year in high school.
Wait, Kanav. Kanav had raised hand. Yes, Kanav.
Mariam.
Do you know the full name by any chance? You'll get the points, but can you tell the full name?
No, sir, I don't know.
He had raised the hand with the first clue. Yes. Wait, can you tell us what made you think of Mariam, Kanav?
Sir, I just knew some mathematicians and field medalists.
Okay.
So just like this Iranian mathematician, I just knew Maria.
Okay.
All right. So we can give him 400 points, but the full name is Maria Mirzekhani. Okay. Let's look at the other clues. So actually, it's great that he got it because there was no mention of her gender in the first clue. So that's a good answer, Kanav. So she always wanted to be a writer and only thought of becoming a mathematician until the last year in high school. Won gold medals twice in IMO in 1994 and 1995 with a perfect score in 95. And in the last clue, you get to know that she was a girl and she died at a very early age of cancer. And I think as of now, she is the only woman Fields medalist. And she passed away, I think, when she was only 40. So yes, the correct answer is Mariam Mirzekhani. 1977 to 2017. Okay. Very nice. Moving on. The first clue is, was the fellow of the Royal Society and worked as a professor at Princeton University and also made a lot of contributions to recreational mathematics. Okay. Does anybody have an answer to that? No. Okay, the second clue. Coined the word monstrous moonshine, came up with the doomsday algorithm, the free will theorem, look and say sequence, and more. Anyone else? No. Okay, next. This is his picture. Shreyas, yes.
Is it John Conway?
Well done, it's John Conway. That's a good answer. And let's look at the fourth clue. He's also famous for his Game of Life, a game that he developed, which is a zero-player game. It's probably my favorite invention in mathematics. And I would like to tell you all that I had the very good fortune of running into Conway when I was visiting Princeton 3 years back. And I had a lengthy conversation with him. And I'm such a fool. I was not as smart as you guys. I didn't know who he was. So I spoke to him for 1 hour. I clicked a picture with him. And then I asked him for his name. I went home and I Googled and I felt I was the luckiest person ever. And he passed away very recently, so I consider it to be a very, very fortunate thing that happened to me that I met him, and he gave me some very good advice. And it was at that point of time that I decided to pursue mathematics seriously after talking to him. Very, very inspirational figure, John Conway. Okay.
And Raghav, by the way, has made something called as Game of Primes, probably inspired from Game of Life.
Yes, yes. I was totally inspired by him, and I created something called the Game of Prime, which is under development at this point of time. Maybe next year or 2 years later, it will be a little more substantial. So we have reached the end of the quiz, and I request all of you to apologize for a few blips that I had here and there, because I was not very sure how many questions are remaining. I'm sorry about that. But it was great fun interacting with all of you. And I would like to finish off with this quote by the man himself, Swami Chinmayananda, who said, "Victory is not in the trophy won, but in the race run." The very fact that all of you made it to this final round from such a large pool of people, and remember, the pool of people might even be larger, because there are people who didn't even participate because they didn't feel that they had the chance in the first round. So you not only went there, you participated in it, you got selected for this round, and this was a very tricky, interesting quiz with a lot of rules, and you did such a good job. So I congratulate all of you.
Here is the announcement of the prize winners of the final round of Sridhara Math Contest. At third position, we have a tie between Shreyas and Aishwarya, whose scores are at 200. Congratulations. At second position, we have Devin with score of 250. Congratulations, Devin. And the winner, the first position, goes to Kanav with 550 points. Congratulations to all the prize winners.
Congratulations, Kanav. If I remember rightly, he started off with almost nothing in the first round, but he did so well to come back. And I really, the hats off to Kanav and everybody else for doing such a good job. I say goodbye from my side. I would like to hand it over to Vinay sir. Once again, guys, thank you so much. It was a great pleasure being a quiz master with such wonderful talents. Thank you to Raising a Mathematician and also CVV for organizing this whole thing. Thank you, Vinay sir, for giving me this opportunity. Hand it over to Vinay sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Raghav. I'm sure all of us who were not the participants, we really enjoyed you doing the quiz. And participants, it was wonderful. I mean, we all were on our toes when you guys were answering, and it was really fun to see how you guys were trying to catch up with each other. So great going, guys. I really enjoyed. And best wishes to all of you. Congratulations to all of you who participated in this. And all of you, all seven of you, you did really well in the elimination round. So this is nothing to judge based on, how much you know or something like that. This is more luck, a lot of factors are depending on luck as well over here. So the scores and prizes don't determine who you are. So I just want to say that to everybody, and my congratulations to all the participants. And I hand it over to Ajayji. Ajayji, over to you.
I would like to repeat what Vinayji said. I was personally thrilled to see all you participate, and the way you answered the questions, the way you approached it. I must say congratulations to one and all, and especially to the winners. I now request Nagaraji and Gauriji also to congratulate our participants and say a few words about the quiz. How was your experience with this quiz? Nagaraji?
Sure. It was very exciting. And I don't need to tell these participants, how exciting mathematics is. But who are especially sports fans, they go to the sports arena, they see a football player scoring a goal or a cricket player hitting a six and so on, how they get excited. And they really cannot imagine that similar excitement is there when students answer questions about mathematics. They cannot really understand that. So there is a contest called Math Counts in US. It is very, very popular. And I saw one of them when I was in Washington, D.C., several years ago, and one of my friends was a participant. He was also a precocious mathematician like Raghav. He was participating. I went to see, and it was amazing how exciting it is. It's all about an opportunity to see a human mind think. And if you ask me, that is the greatest wonder of all. And it's when you see a person think, if you can watch it, you can really see it happening. I think that you really see God. So I think that is the hidden meaning in Ramanujan's saying that the expression of God. It is the pure thought, something that I had not thought about it before, you had not thought about it before, something triggers that thought in your mind. I really, really think that's where God lies. I have no doubt about it. And it's a great way to demonstrate. Raghav, you brought out the best in the participants. I'm very proud that you're from Manipal. I'm from Kasaragod, Mangalore area myself.
Thank you, sir. So, thank you.
You know, hope to run into you sometime when you come back or when I go back, either way. So very excited. So Vinay, Ajay, thank you very much. It's a great show. And guys, you guys are lajawab.
So I take this opportunity to thank each and everyone involved with this, our IT team, our media team, and the RAM, Raising a Mathematician Foundation team, especially Shreyas G, Hariharan G, and our scorers. It was a great pleasure associating with you and organizing such a contest. I'm sure we will associate again and come back with the second season of Sridhara Math Contest. And it was a great fun. I wish all the youngsters the very best. Hope you take up a career in mathematics and hope to see you in various avenues. And especially, you are always welcome to CVV.